Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. We bless your name. We thank you, Father. We honor you, Lord, my God, my Father. In the name of every chain holding your husband, I cut them into pieces. I cut them now in the name of Jesus. Let every chain be broken. Let every chain fall down in the name of Jesus. Lose them, lose them, lose your people in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We bless your name. We give you the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen, amen. Amen. Thank you very much. I welcome everyone, first timers, newcomers, welcome in the name of Jesus. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Ontario. I hear standing with you. It is a war, so we have to fight. It is hard. God will not come from heaven to do to do for you. It is me to stand on the gap to pray for you.
Yes, Lord.
Today we are having this meeting, and we will have midnight.
Yes.
Midnight today, midnight. Yes. So we will end our prayer tonight, midnight.
Yes, Father.
So you join us midnight tonight, so that they will be prophetic midnight prayer.
Yes, yes,
you are not, if you are not working, if you are there, or you will come late. You receive the anointing. We'll share. So, people of God, I want to thank you so much for coming and receive the prophetic message from the prophet's table. I will tell you that God has prepared for you something better than what you think of.
Yes,
so, I'm want to tell you that God loves you and He's prepared your partner.
Yes, Lord.
If you are engaging with the wrong partner, sorry.
Yes.
It is going to be destroyed because I prayed. If he says he's leaving you, don't worry. It's not for you. He will come to give you trouble. So everyone who is having a wrong partner, as from midnight today, they will say bye-bye. If they will stay, that's the one.
Bye-bye.
In the name of Jesus. Even those who have called me, they say they have already found a bond. I will pray tonight that if they are not from God, they will scatter in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, Father. I thank you, Lord, my God. I thank you for the people you have given me. The Bible says where two or three are gathered in the midst is there. Therefore, I thank God that you are there in the name of Jesus. You have come. I thank God that you are here to listen. And God will bless you. Thank you very much. I'm going to bring my sister, the prophetess Miriam, to pray for you. Then from there I will continue. Sister, welcome.
Amen.
Welcome in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Well, children of God, we thank God for Jesus. And we thank God for this blessed day, for this is the season that God has chosen to loose every heavy band of the enemy that has tied you all and all of us for so many years. And when you go to Jeremiah 40, verse 4, the Lord said He's breaking every chain from our hands, our feet, everything that had beheld us and held us back for so long. But this is our set time with Psalm 102, verse 13. He said, yes, the set time of this favor has come upon us. So it's a season of favor. It's a season of glory. And I'm here to tell you all that rejoice. Rejoice because the hour is come and now is. Rejoice and give God thanks to God because He's ready to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can think or ask of, according to the Holy Ghost power within us. So, saints of God, rejoice and thank Him because I prophesy that your life will never be the same after today. After the woman of God has prophesied, I decree and declare that the set time of your marriage, your finances, the glory that God has placed upon you for many years, that glory is rising after the order of Isaiah 60 verse 1 to 3. Yes, it's shining. The glorious glory is coming forth upon you. And you know Isaiah 43, 18 and 19. He said that He's doing a new thing in our lives. A new thing, and it's springing forth, and all your enemies, all the unfriendly friends, all those that never like you, they're going to hear about it, and they cannot stop you because you are unstoppable. You are unchangeable. You are on power. You are powerful, and everything that God said, so it is. Nobody can stop you because Jesus said it, and it is so. So I'm here to prophesy to you that whatever the prophetess has told you, it is true and it is well, and it shall surely come to pass. It shall surely come to pass, and all these two shall come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the name that is above every other name, that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that in the heavens, beneath the earth, and in the earth it will bow, because Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. In your lives, in our lives, to the glory of God our Father. So believe it, trust Him that this is His hour. You're going to see it happen suddenly when you don't even expect. God is bringing you your partner, your husband, your wife, the glory, your finances, every broken vertex in your life. He's putting it all together this day, this hour, in Jesus' name. Amen. Be blessed and thank God for your life. Amen. Peace. Amen. Shalom, shalom.
Amen. Bye. Amen. 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 Receive it. Receive it. I receive mine too. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Yes, I am going to talk this to you. This is the mother of Alison. Alison, I met her in Periscope. She followed me. She came for deliverance. She can testify what she saw yesterday. Mm-hmm. There was a deliverance yesterday. A man came from nowhere. A white man came from nowhere and they received his deliverance. So your deliverance is coming. If you leave Toronto, Brampton, or anywhere in Mississauga, wherever, you are welcome to come Friday deliverance. You are going to receive your breakthrough. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. Lord, we love you, Jesus. Yes, we thank you, my God. Yes, Lord, my God, we give all the glory, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Alison. Alison, say amen. That is the one who is saying yes, it's true. She was there yesterday and she saw with her own eyes what happened there.
Yes.
We see people get free.
Yes.
You see, the person was roaring like a python, like a snake. And the person was set free.
Yes.
Thank you, thank you. There's always a witness. So if you want to come and experience the deliverance, you are welcome.
Mm-hmm.
We have Friday is our day of deliverance. So you come where you can scream, where you can be helped.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much. Thank God bless you. So I'm going to talk to you the prayers to ask God to reveal secret of your partner before marriage. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, he got freedom, my dear. Yes, the man was set free. So the topic I'm going to talk is prayers to ask God to reveal secret before marriage. You know, I was talking early this morning that you don't have to rush to your marriage. There are many marriages that are very shallow. No love. It is just for beauty and handsomeness.
Mm-hmm.
To marry a woman because of beauty or to marry a man because of handsomeness is like buying a house because of the paint.
Mm-hmm.
There are marriages where the couples are in adultery.
Mm-hmm.
They are beating and beating marriages.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to check before we marry that we are not marrying the paint, we are not marrying the car, we are not marrying the beautiful person.
Yes.
Whether your partner, wherever you God brings you, wherever he is, don't look at that. There were some people who were trying to look the beauty and the height of the person, but God rejected them. So you will not be a portion of being rejected by God. You cannot be rejected by God.
Amen.
You know that some people God has rejected them. So I hope you will not be the one.
Mm-hmm.
As I'm going to talk to you, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As I'm going to talk to you, this computer, something is not right. And once you are in marriage and you began to experience the following in your dreams, you know that all these are attacks against your marriage. So if like now, when you see any dream, or you are in marriage, but you have very strange dreams, sex in dreams, seeing dirty wedding gowns, seeing yourself marrying strange persons, losing your shoes. Shoes represent marriage. If you lose your shoes in your dream, that means you have to pray, you have to go for prayer and fasting, or you have to look for a deliverance person, because that is, the shoes represent marriage. Shaving of your hair, shaving of your hair is to take your glory. Mm-hmm. When you see you dream somebody shaving your hair, that is taking your glory.
Yeah.
Going to church on your wedding day and meet an empty chair's hall, it means that the enemy has already taken your wedding. You have no wedding. They have taken your wedding. Finding yourself in the marketplace wearing dirty and garment, it seems that the enemy wants you to make you vulnerable. So please, watch your dreams before you connect yourself. The enemy is making you to be distracted, so you don't need this. I pray that God will deliver you. Especially if you have dreams in your sex in dreams, it's very bad. You have to command that man to die. You cut them off. You cut them to pieces in Jesus' name. So I pray that God will deliver you from this. As we pray, as the topic says, pray prayers to ask God to reveal secret of your partner before marriage. I'm going to read from the scripture, the book of Psalms 25 verse 14. The book of Psalms 25 verse 14. The Bible says, the secret of the Lord is with them that fear him, and he will show them his covenant. So the Lord, you fear the Lord. So the secret of the Lord is those who fear him. Because you need the truth, and God will reveal his covenant. This man is a covenant man. This woman is a covenanted woman. You didn't get the woman from the tree. You didn't get the woman from the road. It is a covenant. That's why you make a vow. You covenant. You say, I will die. Daddy will separate us. Then you say, yes, I do. Do you love this person? Yes, I do. So, well, yes, I do. The devil is shaking his head saying, yes, yes, because you married a python, you married a snake. And then after a few months, after a few years, problem starts. But God is merciful God. He can restore your marriage. He can kill that python. He can kill that snake that has entered in your house. He can kill that spirit wife, spirit man that has entered your house. So, as the Lord find you, if God has find you married like that, God would have mercy and deliver you. But you, before you marry, ask God to fulfill the secret of the partner that you are going to marry. So if you marry a wrong person, then you expect God to, you pray God to help you, and I've told you that before you marry, go and pray. Hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, my God and my Father. I want to thank you, Lord. Yes, God, my Father. I pray that God will reveal to you the secret of your partner so that you don't get a wrong person. Listen, let me repeat this again. If you marry, you have trouble, your marriage is in trouble right now because you didn't choose a right person. God has mercy. He can renew your marriage, he can restore your marriage, and he can kill the serpentine. He can remove all that spirit wife, spirit husband. He can renew your marriage. He can renew your marriage and you become new. But if you go from here, as you listen this prayer, you go and choose a wrong person, then you expect God to be there. Instead of God, it will be the devil. And the devil will start dancing. When are you finished the wedding? Soon. Then you go home and then he started bringing trouble. So the marriage cannot last. It will last a few, you can enjoy a few days. before you notice problem is coming, some men, they end up beating their wives, even they remove their teeth from the mouth. Within no time, the woman is no teeth in the mouth. They is fighting. Because you have choose the wrong person, you didn't ask God to reveal the secret of your partner. God is able to reveal it. If you don't listen to God, come to me. Come to the prophet. Go to the prophets. There are so many prophets nowadays. Don't go to the false prophet who will rely on you. God will reveal to you, and not only you alone. He will reveal to your pastor, even to your pastor. I always tell people, don't make the mistake which your father did, your parents did. You are a different person. Therefore, you have a choice to choose the right person. Watch your dream. If you have a wrong person, the Lord will warn you in the dreams. He will show you the dreams. And then you, if you don't know the meaning of your dreams, call me, I will help you. That's why I give the numbers to help people here. And they don't come to blame and say, no, we didn't know. I love the person so much, I will pray for the person. You will pray until tomorrow. Nothing will happen to you. Because you didn't listen to God. You didn't listen to the voice of God. You didn't listen to the warnings that God was giving you in the dreams. God is speaking to me right now to listen and change your behavior. Then God will bless you. The Bible is here for you to meditate upon and pray very hard before you connect. As I said earlier in the other video, that since we are praying this, the enemy, the agent, the devil, will try to bring his own agent, but it is not you. Wherever any agent of the devil, any child of the devil will come to you as a husband or as a wife, shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. I pray that God will direct the right person who you will love and care, who you will be helper, and he will be your husband. Remember the book of Proverbs was saying that you are a noble woman. And the husband said, you are the wife. And I said, you say, I am the woman. Therefore, you claim that scripture. I am praying that God will reveal to you the secret of your partner before you marry. Ask him, even the parents, ask him, where is that person come from? Who are the people? The Lord will show you. He will not deny anything. You will see a dream or you will hear the person talking like the way I'm talking to you. Praise the Lord. I said, I wish I knew this. I wish I could have somebody to talk to me like this. I didn't have anybody. I told you that this deliverance, I got it by myself. The Holy Spirit, God sent his angel to bring this deliverance to me. I didn't have anybody to teach me or to tell me what I know now. Everything I learned by myself and very hard way. After I was sick, admitted in the hospital, very sick, and I was like losing everything, is when God, who came to me through an angel, to teach me what I'm telling you. God is my witness, and I know that this deliverance, I didn't get free. I had to pay dearly through my body, through my life. I was sick. I went to so difficult life. I escaped death so many times. I escaped dead all the time. Dead was coming to me, but I was escaped. God was protecting me. The time even when I was in the bomb blast, that is the time I could have died. But God still saved my life. Self-accident. I got a lot of accident. When I was driving myself, I get self-accident. When I hired the driver to drive me, I get the accident. I said, okay, let me go to the bus. I still get accident in the bus. Wherever I was trying, I was getting accident. Until I said something is not right. So, what I know now, what I have, I didn't have anybody to tell me. So, you are lucky to be in Periscope to hear this. I am telling you the truth. Seek the Lord to reveal to you the secret of your partner. According to that Bible, the scripture says, the Psalms 25 verse 14, the Bible says, the secret of the Lord is with them that fear him, and he will show them his covenant. The secret of the Lord, the secret of the Lord is with them that fear him. God always has secret to the people who fear him. He will never let you go without telling you anything. He would never let you, anything would never happen to you without revealing his servant. So God always revealed the secret. He always revealed things before it happened. And you can be my witness and say, sorry, I had a dream of this person, but I didn't know what to do. God has been warning you that this person is a bad person. Don't follow him. But because you don't know what to do, you think it's fine. So I pray that God will open your eyes and your ears to hear him clearly so that you don't enter into this big, big, big disaster. Let's look in the book, another book from the book of Daniel. The book of Daniel 2 verse 2. The Bible says, then the king commanded to call magician and the astrologist and the sorcerers and the Chaldeans for to show the king his dreams. So they called and stood before the king. Now the king had a dream, and he commanded, he called all the people, the astrologers, magicians, sorcerers, and Chaldeans to show the king the dream he had. But they were not able to interpret the dream. They did not, even the sorcerers, the astrologers. So that's showing you that the Lord will hide the secret to witchcraft, sorcerers, astrologers, but he will reveal it to his people. He will reveal it to his servants. David was, Daniel was the servant of God, whom we loved God, and God revealed him the dream of the king. So it's Daniel who told the king the dream. All the people he depends on, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. thank you so much. Yes, I'm telling you that God is good. So, people go to an astrologist or to witch doctor or to witchcraft to get their spouses, to get their partners. It will not do them good because them also they need God. Look at this. They want the king palace. They want the king. But they were not able to tell the king the dream, the meaning of the dream. But God revealed the secret to his people. So the Lord will reveal the secret to you, to know who is this person. If he's a good person, God will tell you, go ahead. But if he's a wrong person, God will indicate. You know, indication. When you want to branch, when you drive a car, and you go, you put the indicate. You indicate that you are going in this way. If you indicate and you don't turn, then you will danger the other drive. It will be too bad. If the red line shows red, if you don't stop, what will happen? You will get into accident and you will kill other people, innocent people. You will even kill yourself. So, red always, God will show you red. Red is coming. First of all, he will show you orange. To be ready, for red is coming. So, he shows you indication. Orange. Then after orange, what do? You slow. When you see orange, you slow a little bit. Then before red. Then after red, you slow it. Then God will open for you clean. Then say, look at this. This is the type of the man you wanted to marry. People of God, I want to tell you that always God shows signs before you get into that. I am asking the Lord Almighty that God will bring your partner that will love you, and he will give you the right one in Jesus' name. I pray that God is ready to release your partner. They have been chained, they have been binding, they have been buried. I am calling from every corner of the world to release your partner in the name of Jesus. I thank God for your life. I bless you and I thank God so much. God will help you. Tonight I'm going to release prophetic words and call upon your partner everywhere from four corners of the world, and they will come. Forget the drunkard one. Forget those people who are wandering in the streets. The Lord has his own people and he will connect them to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. I have to stop here. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isik, saying bye-bye to you. Remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. And also, you call our numbers, call me. especially this, I thank God because many people have been calling me. Called my number, my cell phone number is 647-608-5207. Treasure and Deborah, wherever who is in the line, you know those numbers, pull them up. So you can put them for the people to see. If they want to call me, they are most welcome. Thank you very much. God bless you. And see you tonight, midnight. Midnight, 12 midnight, I will be on and I'm going to prophesy to you and speak the live word to you. Then you call me for your wedding. I want to marry you in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. Anywhere in the world, I will come. If it is your wedding, call me, invite me, I will come. Yes, treasure, that's the number. Thank you so much. Thank you, Beat. Thank you. God bless you. Your power is coming.